அவர்களே தேசிய கல்லூரியின் துணை தலைவர் திரு ஜெய்சங்கர் கிருஷ்ணமூர்த்தி அவர்களே தேசிய கல்லூரியின் செயலாளர் ஸ்ரீ ரகுநாதன் அவர்களே தேசிய கல்லூரியின் இருப்பினர் டாக்டர் கே அன்பரசு அவர்களே தேசிய கல்லூரியின் செருக்குழல் உறுப்பினர் ஸ்ரீ என் எல் ராஜா அவர்களே தேசிய கல்லூரியின் முதல்வர் டாக்டர் ஆர் சுந்தரராமன் அவர்களே அனைவருக்கும் வணக்கம். தேசிய கல்லூரியின் நூற்றாண்டு விழாவில் நான் உங்களுடன் கலந்து கொள்வதில் மிக்க மகிழ்ச்சி அடைகிறேன். இந்த சந்தர்ப்பத்தில் இங்கு வந்திருக்கும் பெற்றோர்களுக்கும் ஆசிரியர்களுக்கும் மாணவர்களுக்கும் என்னுடைய மனமார்ந்த வாழ்த்துக்கள். மை டியர் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ், டீச்சர்ஸ், பேரண்ட்ஸ் அண்ட் வெல் விஷர்ஸ் ஆஃப் திஸ் இன்ஸ்டிடியூட் அண்ட் மை டியர் பிரதர்ஸ் அண்ட் சிஸ்டர்ஸ், இட்ஸ் மை ப்ளெஷர் டு பி ஹியர் வித் ஆல் ஆஃப் யூ ஆன் திஸ் மொமெண்டஸ் அகேஷன் ஆஃப் த இனாகரேஷன் ஆஃப் த சென்டினரி செலிப்ரேஷன்ஸ் ஆஃப் நேஷனல் காலேஜ் திருச்சிராப்பள்ளி. த நேஷனலிஸ்ட் ஃபிலாசபி ஆஃப் three committed teachers from this town, as was explained, Sri G. Seshayengar, P. G. Sundaresa Sastrigal and Sri B. S. Venkatramana Sharma led to the setting up of a school in June 1886, I am told. By June 1919, this humble undertaking had grown leaps and bounds to become a full-fledged college thanks to the efforts of Justice T. V. Seshagiri Iyer, ஸ்ரீ டி தேசிகாச்சாரியர், ஸ்ரீ என் டி சுப்பிரமணிய ஐயர் அண்ட் ஸ்ரீ சிவராமகிருஷ்ண ஐயர். மை செலுடேஷன்ஸ் டு ஆல் திஸ் கிரேட் பீப்புள் ஹூ ஆர் இன்ஸ்ட்ருமெண்டல் இன் செட்டிங் அப் திஸ் கிரேட் இன்ஸ்டிடியூஷன். ஐ ஃபீல் பிளெஸ்ட் டு விசிட் த காலேஜ், ஃபீல் வெரி ஹாப்பி வேர் த லிமினரிஸ் லைக் ஃபாதர் ஆஃப் அவர் கிரேட் நேஷன் மகாத்மா காந்தி, த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் பிரைம் மினிஸ்டர் ஆஃப் இந்தியா பண்டிட் ஜவஹர்லால் நேரு and Sri Sardar Vallabhai Patel, many more like that have addressed the gathering on various occasions. I can very well imagine the ups and downs and the challenges that an institution that stood firm for 100 years must have endured and overcome. I congratulate the management for enabling the sustained growth of this institution. I am happy to learn the college has been catering to the educational needs of the downtrodden communities from the villages of Tamil Nadu. When the national average of gross enrollment ratio, GER, in higher education stood at 26.3% in 2018-19, Tamil Nadu topped the nation with 46.9% gross enrollment ratio. I compliment the state of Tamil Nadu for the same. I believe that this feat has been achieved because of the dedicated efforts of institutions such as the National College that cater to rural areas. My dear sisters and brothers and youngsters, with its large network of education institutions, India holds an important place in global education industry. India has the world's largest population in the age of bracket of 5 to 24 years of about 500 million. And this presents a great opportunity for our education sector to grow. For the last few decades, saw the expansion of the education sector to cater to the explosion in demand. I believe that the coming decade must be a time for consolidation, a time to evaluate the gains made so far, a time to introspect and identify gaps, and a time to chart a new path to move forward so that we become a strong, stable, prosperous nation of the world. Literacy in India has been one of the key deterrents to the socio-economic progress of the country. Although our literacy rate has risen significantly from 17% in the end of 1950s to 76% currently, India still has the largest illiterate population in the world, which is with its literacy rate remaining below world average of 86%. Even today, 18-20% of our people are still illiterate, cannot read and write. It's a challenge to us. India was known as Vishwaguru once upon a time. students from across the globe used to come to Nalanda, Takshashila, Pushpagiri, Vikramshila, many of the places to study. Then why are we lagging behind? It's a challenge to all of us, to the institutions, to the management, to the students, to the staff, to the politicians at the state and the center level, to see that we achieve 100% literacy at the earliest. That is a challenge before all of us. It cannot be met by government alone. It has to be a collective endeavor of all people. See the vision of these great people who have set up this institution. Because they realize that not only government, private initiative also is required. That's how this institution has come, and it's flourishing now. Literacy is the first step to empowerment. Education is for enhancement of knowledge. Education is for enlightenment. Education is for empowerment. And education lastly for employment. But unfortunately, we are wrecking it from reverse. Education means employment. That's not the purpose of education. Yes, it is also one of the purposes. But enlightenment, enhancement of your knowledge, and empowerment of the individual, that is the purpose of education. So literacy is the first step to empowerment. We must hence step up our pace of our literacy campaigns, especially those that have an impact on our adult literacy. Though India is home to primary institutions like IISc, IIT, IIM, IIIT, NIT, only 56 institutions were featured in the 500 universities that made it to the Times Higher Education World University Rankings 2020. However, not a single Indian university features in the top 300 list. Why? This is an issue. This is not to criticize anybody. This is an issue of all of us, particularly people who are working in the academic field. They should really introspect. They should find out means and ways. NIT, you have Tiruchirappalli. NIT, no? Or is it engineering college? Tiruchirappalli. You have prestigious institutions in Tamil Nadu, across the country. Why are we lagging behind? This land, this air, this water, particularly of Kaveri, is very fertile. Lands are fertile, brains are fertile, but still why are we lagging behind? Our children, our people who have gone abroad, they are making waves. You see the international companies, multinational companies, top people are from India, and some of them from South India. Nadella Satya, Indira Nui, Sundara Pichai. The latest appointment of Chief Economic Advisor, Geeta Gopinath, is from Karnataka. And you go to Silicon Valley, USA, every second girl or boy is from India and second person is from South India. Then why are we lagging behind? So you need encouragement. You need recognition. You need skill upgradation. That should be the top of the agenda of all education institutions. In ancient times, India was the education capital of the world with its legendary institutions like, I said, Nalanda, Takshashila, Vikramshila. India was the seat of wisdom, cradle of civilization, the Vishwa Guru or the teacher to the world. Education in ancient India was free, egalitarian, and accessible to both men and women. The curriculum was comprehensive and placed equal emphasis on the intellectual, emotional, psychological, physical development of the students. If we have to restore this ancient glory, we must endeavor to fortify our modern education system with the wisdom gleaned from our ancient texts and practices, distilled in a relatable, rational, and lucid manner, keeping in view the application of this wisdom in today's real-world challenges. This ancient wisdom is India's uniqueness and its great strength. We will be doing a great injustice to posterity if we do not preserve, protect, promote this treasure trove of wisdom handed down to us by generations of wise men and women. And education must be treated as a mission. My dear brothers and sisters, in the initial days of independence, our great leaders, politicians, they took politics as a mission, education as a mission, health as a mission. But of late, some people started giving it a different connotation, making it a commission, giving a remission, and doing a omission, and leaving the passion, and weakening the nation. We have to understand that we must rededicate ourselves. The people who are in the management, see why they have come forward to run this institution, why they are announcing scholarships and incentives to promote knowledge among the children. The people, well-meaning people in the society, the big business, the industry, they should all come forward to strengthen the educational institutions across the country. My dear sisters and brothers and youngsters, today we dream of being a $5 trillion economy by 2022, born by a stable fundamentals, enabling policies, cutting-edge science and technology, and ingenious innovations. But there are also pockets in the nation where poverty, illiteracy, and social evils persist. 20% are living below poverty, 18-20% illiterate. There are areas where there is social discrimination. People are discriminated upper caste and lower caste, as it's right away birth, upper birth and lower birth. Who said? Did the Vedas sanction this? Did the Upanishads promote this caste system of discrimination? Discrimination. This must put an end. And the students, the people who are educated, they must be in the forefront to end this discrimination. And also we have a great history and civilization where women were given respect. We call India as motherland, not father's land. Matru Bhumi, not Pitru Bhumi. Many of the rivers in the country, Ganga, Yamuna, Krishna, Kaveri, Narmada, Tapati, Mahanadi, Sabari, all are named after women. If you believe in Puranas, I am not asking you to believe. If you believe in Puranas, Saraswati, goddess, education. Parvati, Durga, defense. Lakshmi, finance. That was the importance given even in Puranas also. So why should now we allow our woman, our girl child to be neglected? They should be given importance, they should be given encouragement. That's why the Prime Minister has come out with a scheme of Beti Bachao, Beti Padao, and Beti Badao. It should be part of our culture, and we must continue the tradition of promoting women's education and giving them empowerment. The key to fast-track development while ensuring social justice and equal opportunity to all is a good education. Investing in education is investing in a bright future of the country and its economy. We must therefore step up our investment in education from current 4.6% of GDP to 6% of the GDP, as mandated by, suggested by Niti Aayog. The private sector must also take an active interest in investing in education. The future of India education lies in the effective and efficient models of public-private partnership. We need to also create a pool of teachers who are well-versed with the subjects and also excellent communicators. We must train our teachers to recognize and understand the unique talents of each child and render an educational experience that brings out the best in the students. Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam once said, quote, "Educationists should build the capacities of the spirit of inquiry, creativity, entrepreneurial and moral leadership among the students and become their role models. We must also bring about an immediate shift from rote learning to conceptual and application-oriented learning. India has done very well in certain areas of science and technology, especially in space technology and information and communication technology. In fact, Indian computer science experts work in key positions of leadership in various IT global measures. India has the potential to be the manufacturing hub and the human resource capital of the world." In spite of having such a great legacy, great civilization, there was a setback because of the colonial rule. The foreigners, big one, small one, everybody came, conquered us, looted us, cheated us. cheated our minds also, some of them were going back. That is the weakness we are suffering. We must come out of that colonial mindset. Be Indian, be a Bharatiya, feel proud that you are an Indian, you are a Tamilian. And then try to improve the performance. That should be our goal. And for that, I have been suggesting that the new educational policy, Kasturi Rangan Committee has made some recommendations. All the academic people in the country, they should all apply their mind, suggest to implement the new educational policy with all the modifications that are required. History must be part of the education system. You should know what is the history, what is the contribution made by great people for the liberation of this country. What happened to our country and its freedom, how we lost it, how the disunity, the infighting among our rulers have caused the freedom. This history must be part of our education. We should not continue the colonial history where we are taught that Robert Clive the Great, the person who came and ruled us, ruined us, and we call him as great. We don't talk much about Veera Pandya Kattabomman, Pasumpana Muthu Ramananga Teva, Subramanya Bharati, V.O. Chidambaram Pillai, great Satyamurthy, great Rajaji, great people are there. They are all born here in this land. And also Narayana Guru, adjacent Kerala, Basaveswara, next to Karnataka, Allur Sitaramaraju in Andhra Pradesh, many, Jhansi Lakshmibai, Chhatrapati Shivaji, Savitri Bhai Pure, Jyoti Rao Pure, many social reformers, Dr. Baba Saab Ambedkar, to Sardar Vallabhai Patel, the Iron Man of India, you have unified India, bringing all the 560 provinces together. Our children should be taught about Bhagat Singh, Rajguru, Sukadev, Veera Vanchi. Who is Veera Vanchi? Many of us do not know. What is the contribution of Subramanya Bharati? V.O. Chidambaram Pillai, it's not taught in our schools. Why? We should apply our mind, and the policy maker should think of bringing history. And also, we must also promote, protect, and propagate our Indian languages. We must. I always tell wherever I go, you remember four things. Mother who has given you beautiful birth, don't forget her. Mother forever. Mother includes, of course, father also. Woman, W-O-M-A-N. Man is there in woman also. Second, the Janma Bhumi, the native place where you are born, you should always remember the place wherever you go. Even in future, some of you want to go abroad. Go, land, yearn, and return to serve the motherland. And then mother tongue, the language that has come from mother's womb, the great Tamil, Telugu, Kannada, Malayali, Marathi, Assami, Punjabi, Bhojpuri, Dogri, Kashmiri, Urdu, any language for that matter which has come from mother's womb, that should be preserved, propagated. At home, we should speak in our mother tongue, Tamil only. At home. In the bazaar, why is the need to speak in other language? That's why I have taken it as a mission to propagate that all our state governments' communications, number one, should be in the local official language, number one. Number two, you can have other languages also for others. And the medium of education up to the college, high school, must be in Tamil only to start with. After that, you can. Mother tongue is like your eyesight. Other language is like your spectacles. If you have eyesight, spectacles will work. If you have no eyesight, then you will not get any foresight. Forget about the sight. Even if you wear Ray-Ban glasses also, Zuban se kuch aayega nahi ba. So you have to understand this. I am not against learning any language. Learn as many languages as possible. Learn English also, that is also required. But don't think that unless you learn English, you will not go up. The President of India, the Vice President of India, the Prime Minister of India, many chief ministers to convent, We studied in our mother tongue, but still we were able to reach this position. I come from an agriculture family. I used to walk 3 kilometers a day to go to school. No electricity in my village. Studied in local Telugu language, Telugu medium. But now I have become the second constitutional authority of India. How? So that is not the issue. Germany, Japan, Russia, China, and many economic powerful nations, they have their own medium of teaching. But still, they have become powerful. So don't underbe that illusion. But if you learn English additionally, yes, good. Continue. Promote it. When you speak to others, if that man knows your language, you must speak in that language only. If the other man do not know your language, then speak to him, if possible, in another language. That should be our this thing. Otherwise, it has become a fashion now, even ghar maybe, even in the house also, even when calling Amma also, we don't say Amma, we call Mummy. And the parents also say Babu, say Mummy, Daddy. Why this Mummy, Daddy, Bidi, Jadi? Why don't you say Amma? I'm not talking about Natarajan's Amma. That Amma also is great. That's a different matter. I'm talking of our Amma, mother. Why don't we say Amma, Aya? These are beautiful words, but unfortunately, weakness has developed in our system. We must get back to our roots and then protect our civilizational values. Our colleges, our schools, our institutions must really guide the students to promote our culture, our heritage. Culture is different from religion. I am not talking of religion. You want to worship any god, choice is yours. In India, that you have that flexibility, that liberty. You can believe any number of gods. We already have some crores of gods. You want to add one more god also, no problem. India accepts it. The society accepts it. The question is of respecting this country, its unity, its integrity, its heritage, its culture, its tradition. What our forefathers have given to us, protect and promote. There are many civilizations which are as much old as India. Where are they? The Babylonian, the Roman, the Egyptian, the Greek civilizations are also old. We are also old civilization. But why Indian civilization is thriving? Because we believe in Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu. We believe in Vasudhaika Kutumbakam. We believe that the entire world is one family. That is the philosophy of this country. Share and care is the core of Indian philosophy. We must promote, protect that philosophy, preserve that philosophy, so that India's world is looking towards India. As a Vice President of India, as Minister earlier, I amount to a number of countries wherever I am reaching in the recent years and also receiving dignitaries. They are all showing more interest in India. India is being respected, recognized world over. Everybody wants to invest in India, know about Indian culture, practice and promote Indian culture. See how the yoga has caught the imagination of the people. Modi ji has suggested it in the United Nations. Now more than 170 countries are following yoga. And here in our country, some people have reservation. One boy asked, told me, sir, there is a problem. I said, what is your problem? He said, yoga is good, sir, but yoga means Surya Namaskara. Surya Namaskara. I understood his problem. I said, don't do Surya Namaskara. Do Chandra Namaskara. Do something. I was misreading the youngsters. Yoga is an ancient Indian art. It brings unity of mind and body. It's one of the 64 arts of India. And we should promote it in a big way. Religion has nothing to do with this. And also, my dear youngsters, take care of the nature. The student should be told about the importance of nature. The sun, the moon, the air, the water, the great Kaveri, the forest, the trees, all of them should be respected. We misbehaved with them. Recently, Sadhguru Vasudevji has to take a campaign for preserving the rivers because we spoiled the rivers ourselves. And now we are facing water problem. Luckily, this time, God has been kind to Tamil Nadu. Everywhere water is full. So Natarajan was telling me, Kaveri is full, all are full. Tanks are full. But that is not a permanent phenomenon unless you preserve the water, you conserve the water, you reduce, reuse, recycle the water. Otherwise, you will have problems. The greenery. Now we have climate change. Climate is changing very fast. Delhi, after 119 years, the temperature has gone down to 2.4. And many things are happening. You had a tsunami. Why? Why water got stagnated? Because you blocked all the water bodies, private people, other people, and the agencies were not paying their attention. And society also was not concerned initially. So we must take care of the nature. Nature, culture, together for better future. That should be the guide to all of us. Nature, culture, together for better future. Your future, my future, country's future, and world's future. These are all important things, elementary things that has to be told to the children. Fitness India campaign, the Prime Minister has to give a call for Fitness India. Your fitness. Physically fit because we are now following sedentary lifestyle. All the many of the youngsters are here. Sedentary lifestyle, no physical activity at all. That is no good at all. You must not only talk, you must also walk. You must have some sports. Do some exercise. That is the requirement of the time. Sedentary lifestyle. And second problem is of the food habits. We have started eating junk food. Dr. M.S. Swaminathan says we have food security, but there is no protein security. We are not eating proper food. We are eating again junk food, pizza, burger. And you have so many varieties of food in India, particularly in Tamil Nadu. Varthu kolambu, mor kolambu, idli, sambar, pongal, aapam, chettinadu chicken, beautiful. I did not expect. So many items are available, and they are now becoming world over popular. And we are now, our youngsters, because of the westernization, because of the television, because of some icon sponsoring it, we are getting to, and say people say, sir, instant food, sir. Food cannot be instant. Instant food means constant disease. This has to be understood by all of us. So my dear youngsters, follow Indian food. I am not suggesting you must eat this food, that food, vegetarian food, non-vegetarian food. Avoid onion. I am not saying you want to eat anything, eat. Happily. But eat proteinous food. Eat cooked food. You may be surprised, Vice President of India is talking on such small things about nature, about tree, about water, about food, about exercise. These are the basic things to make a strong nation. You are the future of the nation. My dear children, you are of our future. I am now 70. I play badminton every day morning 1 hour, even today. Why? Not to become some champion or compete with P.V. Sindhu. To make myself fit. Morning I was in Hyderabad. Then I went to Nagpur to address a oriental conference. Now I am here in Tiruchirappalli. Tomorrow morning, I am Srimad Adavan's college. Tomorrow afternoon, I am going to Tanjavur. And evening, I am going to Thyagarajar from Utsava. And then going back to Chennai. Why am I getting this energy? Because of some fitness. So Fitness India is very much required. Yoga is very much required. Yoga is for your body, not because of Modi. Modi ji is our Prime Minister, he has suggested in our interest. Don't look it from political angle. The Prime Minister wanted this nation to become strong. He has given three-line mantra. The mantra was attributed to me. No, it was a mantra of the Prime Minister. He said, reform, perform, and transform. I added inform. Because I was IMP Minister, I said, sir, I will inform the people. Because information with confirmation is more than a nomination. You must give information with confirmation. So, my dear youngsters, all these programs, Swachh Bharat, Clean India, Make in India, Digital India, or Beti Bachao, Beti Padao, Beti Padao, or Yoga, or per drop, more crop, or no use of single-use of plastic, reverse regeneration, all this should become popular people's movement, then only they'll succeed. Mere governmental efforts will not. Any amount of lot of efforts are being made by Narendra Bhai Modi. Not many attempts are being made by our Chief Minister Palaniswamy. Many attempts are being made by others also. But these attempts will succeed only if you people also join the movement and own it as a people's movement, then it will become very much successful. A mighty nation with 130 crore population, with wisdom and knowledge, with so much youth power, 65% of the Indian population is below 35 years, 50% is below 25 years. With such a youth and nation, you have a lot of a future. The World Bank, the World Economic Forum, the International Monetary Fund, the Asian Development Bank, everybody is saying India, if it moves ahead and if there is unity between center and state and if you all work together, India can become the third largest economy in the world. Everyone must fulfill his or her responsibility. It is not to be left to Narendra Bhai and it is not left to be Palaniswamy alone. They are the leaders selected by the people. That's a different matter. We as citizens, we as the future of the country, we have a greater responsibility. And our universities, our colleges must become centers of excellence, of skill development. Research must not be limited to those pursuing a doctoral degree. Undergraduate students in universities must also encourage to undertake research activities. Why this prize for the university best or the first? Is to promote. Research is for the benefit of the common man. The purpose of research and science and technology ultimately should benefit the common man. So with that in mind, everybody must be persuasive, must be innovative, innovation, incubation. This is a new buzzword. My dear youngsters, when we were studying, there is no innovation. There is no startup. You know, we go to school late, the teacher used to stay stand up on the bench. Now it is startup, not stand-up. Stand-up on the bench. You have a great opportunity. You have great facilities. You have encouragement. Take care of these encouragements and become knowledgeable. Upgrade your skills and move on. Follow discipline. Discipline is one important aspect. Aim high. Dream high. Dream alone without working. You will not come up. So aim high, dream high, but work hard and do with discipline. We are an independent country. We have to develop a positive mindset. Everything is being opposed by some people. Negative, negative. Hey, bhai, that was a foreign rule. Now you are having your own rule, home rule. Play your role. In a constructive, we must be constructive, not obstructive or destructive. We are seeing in sometimes some protests. Protest is a part of democracy. Dissent is part of democracy. But we should not allow it to be disintegrated. We should not allow destruction of the public properties. We should not allow violence to take place in any public activity. Because peace is the prerequisite for progress. If you have tension, you cannot pay attention. Understand this. So we should not create any tension. And democracy means expressing one's own views. But in a democratic manner, in a peaceful manner, because we want to become a strong and stable nation, should we compete for that or we should compete and have controversies unnecessary, spoil our institutions, spoil our own future, waste our own time? parents, how much money they are spending, how they are taking care of you. They are working hard in the fields, agriculture people. Rural artisans, they are sending all of you to colleges and universities. I am not talking to National College, Tiruchirappalli, I am talking to the entire country. Because when the Vice President speaks, it will go national. We must keep that in mind. Do not allow our time to be wasted. Nothing wrong in knowing different ideologies, but practicing ideology should be once you are out of education institution. You must understand, but at the same time, your focus should be in academic excellence for your better future. We must be pragmatic. We must all pursue education with all the vigor. Our students must draw inspiration from our glorious history to create a magnificent future. Another important message I would like to communicate, emphasis is of environmental protection, as I explained to you. Please focus on protecting environment. We are but merely trustees of this planet. It is our sacred duty to pass its bounties on to the future generation. So take care of the nature. Last but not the least, let us stress that education institutions form the central pillar of every civil society. In their duty to raise intelligent, honest, specially conscious, ethical and compassionate citizens who will safeguard the democratic ethos of this diverse and vibrant nation, it is the duty of these people. We must inculcate cultural, social and moral values in our students. For this to happen, the education we provide must compulsorily be value-based and holistic. When I was a student, we used to have a gardening class, craft class, PT class. Now some of them are missing. We used to have a moral science. Now science remains, morals we are forgetting. We must have morals. We must have values. I'm happy that the National College is focusing some of these important aspects. I call upon all the people, particularly youngsters, try to be inquisitive, try to be scientific, and also keep the culture heritage. Preserve our traditions, follow the great values given by our forefathers, and then try to develop your own personality. And do not discriminate people on the basis of caste, religion, or region. Your language is great, but do not discriminate against others. Don't downgrade any language. As I was telling, try to learn as many languages possible. I can tell you, I'm saying it from Tiruchirappalli, nothing wrong in learning Hindi, but Hindi should not be forced on anybody. That's why my formula is no imposition, no opposition. That is the position. No imposition, no opposition. This has to be understood by all. I am from this part of the country. I became the president of a ruling party. As I could know the language spoken by many people, I was able to manage, though I hail from the south. Try to understand. You want to become leader of your own town, or your district, or your state, or your region, or you want to become something in your nation, in your country. So you must try to. Alag bhasha, alag vesh, phir bhi apna ek desh. Vividhata mein ekata, Bharat ka visheshata. Irrespective of caste, creed, sex, religion and region, India is one, one nation, one country, one people. This feeling has to be grown among us. What is happening in Kashmir must be a matter of concern for the Kanyakumari. What happened to Kanyakumari flights? Must be a matter of concern for the country. What happened in Kerala floods should be a matter of concern for all the states in the country. That sort of national feelings, nation. That is what is required. And it should be developed from the younger age. And we should not try to discriminate things on the basis of caste, on the basis of religion, on the basis of region, on the basis of gender. These things are not part of our culture, they came in between, we must throw them out. So we have a bright future, and if we all work together, and we all join together, and work hard, India will again attain the role of Viswa Guru, and we will become a strong, stable, prosperous, harmonious, happy nation. What is required is not mere prosperity alone. What is required is happiness also. Happiness is very much required. For that happiness, you must see to it that you have a good governance. For that happiness, you follow value system. For the happiness, everybody not only should demand for fundamental rights, you must also perform your fundamental duties. You must follow your duty. Then only your rights will be protected. If you follow one-way traffic, you violate, then how do you protect the other man of his rights? If you don't hear the other man, do not allow him to speak, then how do you protect the freedom of speech? If you are not tolerant to the other point of view, and you say, no, my view only is final, then the other man also will say, my view is final. Then who is final? When you go there, then only it will be known. The question is that we must all be tolerant to each other. We must. That's where this civilization, in spite of India's GDP was around 20% or so before colonial mindset rule, in spite of known as Vishwaguru, India never attacked any country. Go through the history, India never attacked any country. English people came, French people came, Dutch people came, Portugal people came, everybody came on you. But we never attacked any country. That is the greatness of this country. And we are now again regaining our potential. And we, for that, we must all stay positive. Work hard. Follow our duties. Maintain discipline, decorum, right from parliament to panchayat, from UGC to your local college. Everybody must follow the age-old traditions, the culture, the ethos, the discipline, the decorum and decency, that so that the country can become strong and stable. Once again, I'm very happy that I've been able to come here, and I'm very happy that thousands of youngsters, they all turn up to this function, to their alma mater. Some of you must be studying, some of you might have studied earlier. Yeah. I would convey my best wishes to all of you. Thank you very much. God bless you. Nandri, unakkam.
Thank you, sir. So, your words of inspiration have motivated us to explore new possibilities. Thank you so much, sir. May I request Mr. Jayakar Krishnamurti ji to honor our chief guest, Honorable Vice President of India. Please, sir.